Fox News learned, and this was the consensus on Fox News the day after, is that the Republican Party had made a huge mistake by selecting McCain as its nominee, because they selected him because they were persuaded that he was he would go to the center, and that he could bring in moderates and people from the center, and that's why they lost. They lost because he was too centrist. He should have gone way right, okay? And yeah. then everything would have been okay.
Yeah.
So I'm happy to hear this kind of talk, because I think that, what it means is that the next time around in 2012, and I'm going to encourage my Republican friends to do this, that they should bring Sarah Palin back to
a really right-wing campaign
that, you know, that they think that the American people really
Dobson, let all those guys pick the candidate again. I got to tell you something. It was in the back of my mind when I watched Barack Obama give this incredible acceptance speech. You know, we've talked about this before on the show, and that is that Bill Clinton believed his first 2 years that he could live a peaceful coexistence with these reptiles, the real Republican reptiles. Well, within the first matter of months, he was attacked with Vince Foster, Whitewater. He became a target that basically disabled him for the first 2 years, and it ended up costing the midterm election to the Democrats. If Barack Obama believes that he can join hands...
And then just to finish that, for the last 6 years of his presidency, he was fighting a rear guard action and, you know, fighting these allegations that he had sex with an intern.
Right, right.
And that disabled his presidency. But you're right. They just immediately started in to discredit him and to destroy him from day one.
He needs to come out. He needs to
come
out.
There was no honeymoon. They immediately went after him.
Exactly. Well, where do you start? To me, you start, first of all, with access. Okay, look, out of everybody on Fox, I really do genuinely, I know this is probably going to be a surprise. Now, I think you like Neil Cavuto too. I really genuinely like the guy. He really does try to reach across and at points try to compromise. I got to tell you, for everybody else, I would completely cut out access. Now, what does that do to Fox? I'll tell you what it does is it has access for ABC, NBC, CNN, but not Fox. That hurts ratings. It hurts. It's a money issue. I'd start there. And then what I would do is I would not let Karl Rove take a breath. I wouldn't let these people get a chance to get their feet. They've already started organizing, as you know. I guess you followed that story last week where all the movers and shakers, the money people in the Republican Party, had already been meeting, kind of like they met with the Sagebrush Rebellion years. What are they going to do about these first 2 years? Well, I know what they're going to do. They're going to go after Obama. So he has to, Bobby. I mean, I'm talking to everybody that I know having anything to do with this camp. I hope you will. He has to understand that he cannot join hands and sing Kumbaya. He's got to go after them hard as a good offense, or he's going to be trampled.
Well, I agree with that. You know, I agree with your assessment of Neil Cavuto, and I'll tell you what I think the difference is with Neil Cavuto is that Neil Cavuto is intellectually honest.
Yeah.
And that's the difference between partisanship, which you see on O'Reilly, which you see with Sean Hannity, and you see with a lot of these
the morning,
Fox and Friends
Fox
in the Morning.
Oh, God.
Right, which they're just not intellectually honest. They have two different standards, one for Democrats, one for Republicans. If you're Newt Gingrich and you're cheating on your wife, it's okay. If you're Bill Clinton, it's not. If you're Ronald Reagan and you look into the camera and say, I did not trade arms for hostages, that's fine. If you're Bill Clinton, look into the camera and say, I did not have sex with that woman, you need to go to jail for that. And it's all, you know, if you're Sarah Palin hanging out with terrorists and people who want to split our country, that's okay. But if you're Barack Obama and you have an acquaintance who, you know, was involved with the Weatherman 40 years ago when you were 8 years old, you're a terrorist,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Et cetera, et cetera. It's a double standard. Now, there's a couple of guys, and, you know, what I was very disappointed in during the whole from the Gingrich Revolution on down is that there didn't seem to be any honest voices within the Republican Party. You had these kind of stalwarts like Bill Buckley and Gary Wills, mm-hmm, who you would expect mm-hmm, would yeah. have some intellectual honesty and some independence from their ideology, but they were total captives of the Republican ideology, the right-wing conservative ideology, and the partisanship. Partisanship is terrible. Partisanship is divisive and it's dishonest. And what partisanship is, it's not when you criticize a Republican, but when you criticize him because he's a Republican.
Yeah.
Or when you criticize a Democrat because he's a Democrat, not for what he did. And when you lose your intellectual objectivity, when you lose your intellectual honesty and attack people because they're Republican and defend people for the same acts within your own party because they're a Democrat or vice versa. There's a couple of people on TV, and I think Cavuto's one. David Gergen.
Yes, absolutely. And sometimes it's tough for him to take those positions, but Gergen does a great job.
Gergen is intellectually honest. He judges everybody. And Ed Rollins, another Republican.
Absolutely.
Two right-wing Republicans who are intellectually honest. I love watching these guys on TV because what comes out of their mouth, you can trust. They're not selling themselves for partisanship. They're not trying to spin it. They're telling you. They'll say, I'm a conservative. Here's what I want. I want McCain to win. But here's the truth.
Well, if you don't think today, if you don't think this whole week, Murdoch has just been agonizing about this issue of access, he is. And I'm telling you, that's my message to the people that I know close to this campaign. And I hope you'll send the same message. It cut off their access.
No, I know. You know, when Kerry was running, and Kerry had indicated publicly and privately that he was going to put me in the government. And I was going on Fox all the time back then.
Yeah, I remember that. Yeah.
And there was, and I was going on Sean Hannity, you know, with the hopes that at some point we'd have a conversation. It never happened. It was always just a food fight.
And he'd turn off your mic, like they did.
Right,
me.
Turned off my mic. I had a lot of funny things happen with him. But he at that time said to me, if you get an appointment in the administration, will you still come on the show? So, you know, they're worried about that.
Oh, they're very worried. Believe me, I'm hearing from a lot of sources they're worried about it. And if the camp will follow through, what this does is this hits Murdoch in his pocketbook, Bobby. Look, what's he got gathered up right now? Who's watching Fox? He has the same old toads watching the same old shows all the time, talking about the same old thing. He cannot expand his market. And I got to just tell you something. If the message will get out, cut off access to this guy, I think it's going to be a powerful lesson for all the media.